We know that there is no tax on agricultural produce. Only on other manufactured products or services you will have tax. And agricultural produce you will not have any tax. So, a farmer produced 1 kilo of wheat. Now, he sold it to a baker for rupees 20 or 50, for instance. So, this doesn't carry any tax. Now, as far as the baker is concerned, his input value is rupees 50 and he makes bread. He has his own expenses to do that. He has invested on it. He has invested his own labor, so on and so forth, packing everything. Let me assume the value added by the baker is about 20 rupees. So, the value of sale is rupees 70. And there is a sales tax or excise duty, whatever it is about 10%. That means 7 rupees is the tax. And he sells it, so the price is rupees 77. So what is, for initially the tax is some percent of the total value of the product. Now, this bread is brought by a restaurant. Okay, so what is the input value? Huh? 50, yeah. 77. Wrong. I said tax never gives any value. So the input value is 70. What is input tax? It is 7. Now, he has converted this bread into a sandwich and he sells it for 100 rupees. That means value added is another 30. So, what is the value of sale? Value of sale. This 70 is the value of input. He has added a value of 30. That means value of sale is 100. There is a 10% sales tax. That means tax that he has to pay is 10. But that bugger has already paid 7 rupees. So what he will do, he will reduce that 7 and pay a tax of only 3 rupees. Now, what is this 3? It is 10% of the value added by him. This 3 is what? 10% of value added by him. So that is why it is called value added tax. How did I arrive at 3? Total tax collected minus tax on input. This is called input tax credit system. This is called what? Input tax credit system. So, by using this input tax credit system, I arrive at a value added tax. So, this is how value added tax works. Got this idea?